Loratadine is a second-generation antihistamine used to manage the symptoms of allergic rhinitis. In this video, let's find found. What is loratadine? What is loratadine used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking loratadine? How does loratadine work? How to use loratadine? What is loratadine? Loratadine, sold under the brand name Claritin among others, is a medication used to treat allergies. This includes allergic rhinitis and hives. It is also available in combination with pseudoephedrine, a decongestant, known as loratadine/pseudoephedrine. It's taken orally. Loratadine was patented in 1980 and came to market in 1988. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. Loratadine is available as a generic medication. In the United States, it is available over-the-counter. In 2020, it was the 73rd most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 9 million prescriptions. What is loratadine used for? Loratadine is a second-generation antihistamine and is used to manage symptoms of allergic rhinitis, wheal formation, urticaria, and other allergic dermatologic conditions. Contraindication. Loratadine is usually compatible with breastfeeding, classified category L2, probably compatible, by the American Academy of Pediatrics. In the U.S., it is classified as category B in pregnancy, meaning animal reproduction studies have failed to demonstrate a risk to the fetus, but no adequate and well-controlled studies in pregnant women have been conducted. Side effects. As a non-sedating antihistamine, loratadine causes less, but still significant, in some cases, sedation and psychomotor retardation than the older antihistamines, because it penetrates the blood/brain barrier less. Other side effects include headache and antimuscarinic effects, such as urinary retention, dry mouth, blurred vision, and gastrointestinal problems. Pharmacodynamic. Like other second-generation antihistamines, loratadine is selective for peripheral H1 receptors. Loratadine does not penetrate effectively into the central nervous system and has poor affinity for CNS H1 receptors. These qualities result in a lack of CNS depressant effects such as drowsiness, sedation, and impaired psychomotor function. Mechanism of action. Histamine release is a key mediator in allergic rhinitis and urticaria. As a result, loratadine exerts its effect by targeting H1 histamine receptors. Loratadine binds to H1 histamine receptors found on the surface of epithelial cells, endothelial cells, eosinophils, neutrophils, airway cells, and vascular smooth muscle cells, among others. H1 histamine receptors fall under the wider umbrella of G-protein-coupled receptors and exist in a state of equilibrium between the active and inactive forms. Histamine binding to the H1 receptor facilitates cross between transmembrane domains 3 and V, stabilizing the active form of the receptor. On the other hand, antihistamines bind to a different site on the H1 receptor, favoring the inactive form. Hence, loratadine can more accurately be classified as an inverse agonist as opposed to a histamine antagonist and prevent or reduce the severity of histamine-mediated symptoms. Half-life. The elimination half-life is approximately 10 hours for loratadine and 20 hours for discarboethoxyloridine. Dose. Allergic rhinitis. 10 mg PO/Q-day or 5 mg twice daily, not to exceed 10 mg Q-day. Urticaria. 10 mg PO/Q-day initially, if symptoms are inadequately controlled after 1 to 4 weeks, may increase to 10 mg bid. Current guidelines state that non-sedating antihistamine doses may be increased up to 4 times the standard dose, for example, to 20 mg twice daily. Evidence of greater efficacy at higher doses are limited, and other antihistamines are preferred. Safety advice. FDA pregnancy category B, no proven risk in humans. That's all the information about loratadine we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video, to update more health information.